Back in August, we made our trip out to Kinzers, PA for the annual Rough and Tumble Thresherman's Reunion Show. And every year when I go there, I end up spending more and more time just checking out these big old steam-powered tractors. The older I get, the more I appreciate these things, the more I appreciate the time that it had to take to build them, the design, the engineering. I mean, it's just insane when you look at these things. You look at a newer tractor, and you look at one of these, and you look at how crude this thing is, but you think, back in those days, this was top of the line. This was a Cadillac. You know, you had a horse to pull your plow and do all your work for you, or you had one of these. If you were lucky enough to have one of these, you know, you were a step above everybody else, that's for sure. You were going to get more work done, but man, it was still a job to run one of these. You watch these guys drive around there, you know, you're running this thing off of steam, so you're burning something to create that steam, and it's hot. There's moving parts everywhere. You know, there's no safety mechanisms in place on one of these things. There's no air-conditioned cab. There's no power steering. It's a huge difference between what you have today and these old things. But man, it is awesome to watch these things just chug around there. They're big. They're heavy. They're slow. But just oodles and oodles of torque. I mean, hardly any horsepower, but just ridiculous amounts of torque. And it was amazing to see what these guys could do with these things back in the day. You know, when they had one of these, they were running anything and everything they could find off of these things just to try to make their days a little bit easier and a little bit more productive. You know, think about it nowadays. You go out there and you hop into a big old John Deere tractor, and you're going to have a cab, you're going to have windshield wipers, you're going to have a windshield, you're going to have air conditioning, you're going to have a radio, you're going to have GPS, you're going to have anything and everything you could imagine. You're going to have power steering. These things were a step above what was available at the time, and you had none of those features and comforts. If you had a roof over you, again, you're going to have more heat trapped in there, so it was a pretty decent trade-off to stay out of the elements, but you know, you couldn't just sit there and let the machine do the work for you. You had to be adjusting your knobs and everything to keep those gauges where you wanted them to be, you know, keep that pressure where you needed it to be. You had to be throwing more wood or coal on the fire. You had to be steering it nonstop because the steering was so loose and sloppy on them. And, I mean, there was just a lot going on with one of these things. It took a lot of attention. It took a lot of time. And it was some work to drive one of these things and go out there and use this to work your crops up all day long. So we just thought we'd share some of these pictures of the big iron that we saw out there at Rough and Tumble's Thresherman's Reunion, and try to encourage any of you that have never seen one of these up close, get out there to a tractor show or a museum or something and check one of these things out. It's unbelievable, you know, the amount of work that went into them and just the designs and the craftsmanship. They're really something to see. You know, there's a lot going on. And every time you look at one, you pick out more pieces and components that you're just kind of amazed by. And you wonder, how long did it take to make just that one part? So that's going to do it for this video here. As always, be sure to subscribe to this channel. And thanks for watching.